Gang violence within the prison system is basically violence that occurs, such as riots, group fights, or individual fights within inmates. These outbreaks occur quite often in prisons and have a lot to do with what race or gang an inmate is or from. Some of the top prison gangs in Texas include the Texas Syndicate, MS-13, also known as Mara Salvatrucha, Hermanos Pistoleros, La Nuestra Familia, and Aryan Brotherhood. Inmates use terms such as a shiv or shank, which is a code word for weapons usually used within prisons across the U.S. A shiv or a shank is any item that has a sharp and deadly edge to it and is used as a knife-like weapon. Inmates have gotten very creative over the years and have found out how to make weapons out of different items such as a plastic spoon, comb, shower sandal, and even a toothbrush. These weapons are in high connections and are used within gang or individual fights. Some injuries become very brutal because of the use of these weapons and even end up with death consequences sometimes. Crowding of prisons has not only become a problem within the state of Texas, but also within the rest of the United States. There is simply not enough space to have offenders incarcerated to serve their full-time sentence. According to Lonnie Hancock, author of Texas, an unlikely model for prison reform, has stated that for the past 30 years, the Texas prison system has steadily jumped from 3% to 11% just in the spendings of operation budgets. Now, why has the spending budgets increased so much? It all goes back to the overcrowding of prisons. This problem arose across the U.S. in the early 1990s because of the Tough on Crime legislation law that the government passed. The law actually reduced crime rates in the United States, but the rates of the prison overcrowdings went up. Texas, however, is coming up with the new ideas on how to get rid of the overcrowding in prisons. What the state has been doing is creating new risk assessment and probation procedures to release a lot of the nonviolent offenders that Texas implies are most likely not going to return to prison. There are many prisons in the state of Texas that the sanitation is very well and clean. Then there are some prisons where the sanitation is very bad and not consistent. Again, the sanitation of a prison has much to do with the overcrowding of inmates. The way that this affects the inmates is by them receiving different types of infections. Many different types of infections that occur while being incarcerated. Inmates have been receiving infections fairly quickly because of the overcrowding and sanitation within the prisons. The number one infection within prisons as of today is known as HIV or AIDS. Others may include tuberculosis, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and a recent infection known as cellulitis. Cellulitis is a serious skin infection that can be life-threatening, such as AIDS or tuberculosis as well. The TCJS, also known as the Texas Commission of Jail Standards, has been creating different educational, recreational, and rehabilitation programs to consist as treatment for these different types of infections.